Welcome back, folks, to Fayetteville Basketball. My name is Coleman Stinnett. My co-host, Derek Collins, will be joining me shortly. But I did sit down with Coach Rimmer earlier today, and here's what he had to say. Welcome back, everybody. My name is Coleman Stinnett, down on the court with Coach Rimmer. So, Coach, a hot week last week, coming off of two road wins. So, can you tell us a little bit about how you're going to carry that momentum into tonight?
Yeah, the hot week was a lot of good shooting. We shot the ball really well from perimeter. We've been scoring a lot of points. Defensively, not doing a great job, but I guess if you score a lot of points, you can get by with that. So to stay hot, I think we've got to continue to shoot the ball well from the perimeter, keep the pace up. That's something we're going to want to do tonight is keep the game really fast.
Yeah. And what are you telling your girls coming into tonight?
Well, Rogers is in a situation where they need to win. Rogers, Harbor, and Fayetteville are all kind of jumbled up below Bentonville right now. And if Rogers wins a game tonight, they kind of keep themselves alive in a conference race. So they're kind of desperate. And desperate teams usually play really well. And so we're going to have to match that intensity level. We're still searching for a conference championship. If we can win out, that's a possibility. So we've got to protect our home court tonight, and that's what we're talking about.
Thank you, Coach.
You bet. Thanks for having me on. I remember hitting them all with the whole team. Not can't answer calls cause I'm balling. I was waking up getting racks in the morning. I was broke, now I'm rich, deep, salty. I've been waking up to get the money, whoa, whoa. Got a bad bitch ass, tatted, whoa, whoa. Da Vinci to my toes, two twins, I'm f***ing them both. I put in new AP, the water like a boat. I was down bad on my dick, what was you niggas at? I know you turned your back on me just to get some racks. I seen you swerve back, cause I'm in the black bag. New diamonds on me.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome again to Bulldog Arena here on the campus of Fayetteville High School for tonight's varsity girls basketball action featuring the Lady Mounties from Rogers High School and your Fayetteville Bulldogs. At this time, we ask that you please stand and face the flag on the east side of the gymnasium as we honor America and those who protect our freedom with the playing of our national anthem. Let's meet the starters for our varsity contest, beginning with our visitors from Rogers High School. Starting at forward, a 5'10 senior, number one, Gracie Carr. Starting guard, 5'8 sophomore, number two, Aubrey Treadwell. Starting at guard, 5'7 senior, number three, Cameron Brockhoff. Starting guard, 5'7 freshman, number 23, Ava Maynor. And starting forward, 5'9 senior, number 33, Taylor Treadwell. Lady Mounties are coached by Preston Early. And now, the starters for your Fayetteville Bulldogs. Starting guard, 5'8 senior, number zero, Ariana Seda. Starting guard, 5'5 senior, number one, Claudia Bridges. Starting guard, 5'10 junior, number 12, Lauren Lindsay. Starting at guard, 5'7 sophomore, number 14, Winter Beck. And starting at guard, 5'11 junior, number 23, Caroline Lyle. Your Bulldogs are coached by Vic Rimmer.
Welcome back, folks. Once again, my name is Coleman Stennett.
And I'm Derek Collins.
And welcome back to the Lady Bulldog basketball. Right now we have Fayetteville starting out with the tip, with Seda at the top of the key, with a drop-off on Winter Breck. Very aggressive play down the stretch. She's got Lyles on the baseline drive, take out Seda, and that's going to be off of fingers and out of bounds. Excuse me. That's going to stay with Fayetteville. I think it's going to be off of Carr. Here's Beck inside the lane with a little bit of a scoop shot there. And folks, we are going off of our knowledge of starting lineups here for Rogers right now. We do not have a roster for them.
Yeah.
So the three ball is good.
Nice.
Good ball movement there. Here is, I believe that's Carr with the steal. Rogers is already out and running with a 3-2 early lead. Off the roll, inside, no good. Aceto with the rebound. Looking for Bridges up ahead, getting picked up on the wing, and with 29 left to play on the shot clock. Here's Lyles over top. Inside, doesn't get her call. Lyles goes up with a jump shot, no good.
Oh.
He's just tripped over. Here's another three ball, yes.
Three with the three. Brockhoff. Whoa.
Bridges bringing out the handles. But it's going to be a foul on the floor. walk off is going to get called for it. First team and first personal. Bridges will start with a fresh shot clock. Here's the kick out. Here's Seda. She's going to get called for the travel. Trying to go baseline. That's going to be Rogers' ball going the other way. Six-two, Fayetteville leads. 5:56 left to play. And picked up by Seda. Here is the pass over, coming over Carr with the screen. Decides to ignore it. But here's Brockhoff, trying to get it inside. Doesn't get anything going in there. Inside, does it too far. Here's Lindsay with a steal. Has Beck out in front, decides not to hit her. Drops it off to Seda at the top of the key. Has Lyles open for three.
Caroline
absolutely. Fayetteville with a slower start than we've seen, but coming off of two road wins against Harbor and Bentonville West last week on the 26th and 29th.
Oh, what the?
I think the ball
kind of just punched her right in the face. She started seeing stars.
Inside, doesn't get anything to go. Here's Beck with the steal, has Seda running with her. Decides to take it all the way. No good. And that's going to be a blocking foul. Beck's going to go to the line to shoot, too. 6-5, the Lady Mounties still lead. 4:58 left to play. One thing we always see from the Lady Bulldogs is just really aggressive going inside.
Yeah, for real.
But you know what? Rogers doesn't seem to be doing. Isn't super far behind because they're knocked down 2-3, so. It's beat over top here in the corner, back at the top of the key. Three ball. Yes.
Oh, my.
2-for-2, and a timeout will be called by Coach Rimmer. Folks, we will also take a timeout, and we'll be right back here after the break.
Dang, so far no misses.
Washington Regional understands the world has changed, but one thing that hasn't is our commitment to your health and your safety. Providing safe, compassionate care is our top priority. Learn more at WRegional.com/safecare.
We want to play. We want to play competitive team activities. Please do your part to help us finish the season. Wear your mask, practice social distancing, and wash your hands.
Across the state of Arkansas, farmers and merchants
And we are right back to action here in Fayetteville. Ariana Seda will start out with the ball for Fayetteville, bringing it down the court, trying to get Caroline Lyles, but doesn't get anything. A good sort of gambling play, and it pays off for Rogers right now. It's a one-on-two situation going up. Doesn't get the layup and a race for the ball. And Rogers is going to end up with it. Here in the corner, Brockhoff. Here comes the screen. Beck will pick up after. It's going to be out of bounds, going the other way.
Good defense from number 23, Caroline Lyles.
Bridges with the step back. She's going to get called for a travel. One too many.
Dang, she rarely ever gets called for travels.
Yeah. Over to Brockhoff. Far left wing. Back up Carr. Getting a screen downhill. doesn't get it to go. That's going to be off of Carr going the other way. Bridges, pop-up three. Yes!
Claudia Bridges! 3 points!
She won't miss a lot of those.
Uh-uh.
And a little bit of momentum here from Fayetteville. Lauren Lindsay with the steal. Underneath is Beck. Easy two.
Perfect play.
Rogers looking to get something going here on offense with two turnovers on the last two possessions. Here's Carr. Popping out outside, getting picked up by Lyles. Lyles kind of sagging down a little bit. There's a tip ball and a steal by Winter Beck. She's got one person to beat, and it's Carr. Decides to take it in all the way. No good. Bridges with the rebound, though. Here in the corner, hits the cutting Lyles. It's going to be a blocking foul. And Lyles will go to the line.
That was crazy. Winter Beck just like... barely touched that with her finger, and it was like deflected.
Lyles, the junior out of Fayetteville. I've seen a lot of her the past 2 years this summer, actually coming off of a knee injury. Picking up a lot of offers, I'll tell you that.
Yep.
A lot of offers.
Whole lot of offers.
Allison Byers are just going to come in for... Beck. And that's good. Nobody's staying back for the Bulldogs. Getting beat over top. It's a 2-on-3 situation. Gets away with a double dribble, it seems, but we'll keep playing. Getting a screen up top, trying to go downhill, doesn't get what she wants. Decides not to go with the back cut, but on the far right wing, takes it baseline inside, intercepted by Bridges. Bridges is out and running. Still the 5-on-5 situation. Pulls up, elbow. Yes!
Oh!
Basket by number one, Claudia Bridges.
That's a big defensive step up, I would say.
Yeah. Definitely.
Just Brock off with the pass out in the corner, getting 3 seconds in the lane. Waiting to see what's happening. I think there was a substitution made. Oh, yep. So Beck and Johnson are now in. Claudia, far three.
Yeah. Oh my God. That was almost from the Bulldog logo right here. Like at the leg, basically.
That was deep. Downhill gets it to go for Rogers. It's their first bucket in a minute. But Bridges racing. Euro step. Yes.
Oh, she's on fire. Someone get a fire extinguisher.
Inside, turnaround Jay, no good. Lyles with the rebound. She's got Johnson, decides to hit. Bounce pass inside, Bridges, yes!
Oh! The right hand. Oh my goodness.
She has 12 in the quarter, folks. Brock off with the pump fake, inside, gets denied by Lyles. Lyles on the floor.
Whoa!
Oh. And it's intercepted by Rogers. Here we go. We got running Brockoff. Corner three, no good. Byers with the rebound. Outlet pass to Beck. Has one person to beat. Beats her.
What is going on?
There's 27 left to play. No more shot clock.
Based on the score, it looks like like the Mounties just kind of lagged out of the game for a little bit, and they were AFK, and then Bulldogs just went crazy.
He said AFK. Brockoff wants to get something going with 9 to play. Here's the kick out, baseline drive, takes it all the way, denied by Lyles. Byers has it, has to get it up.
Get it, shoot it.
shoots it too late. It's the tip of the rim. But I don't think it would have been good after the buzzer. Alrighty, folks, 24-11 headed into the second quarter. We'll be right back to you after this.
Help us complete the season. Please follow all directives pertaining to seating requirements, face coverings, and social distancing.
The Alsog Company Real Estate Team has over 30 years of experience specializing in both commercial and residential listings and commercial leasing. Let Kurt, Andrew, and Brooke help you meet your real estate needs by calling 479-527-8865 or visiting their website at lsawco.com. As part of Lindsay & Associates, the state's largest real estate company, they look forward to working with you and showing you how we bring great neighbors together. Alsog Company and Lindsay & Associates, proud supporters of the Fayetteville Bulldogs.
We want to play. Please do your best to help us continue. Wear your mask, practice social distancing, and follow directives pertaining to seating requirements.
And we are back to action here in Fayetteville in Bulldog Arena. We got Rogers starting out with the ball with the quarter. It's 24-11 right now with Rogers having all five timeouts still. But Claudia Bridges right now is the name of the first quarter.
Yeah.
She had 12 points in the first quarter.
Sheesh.
Top of the key three, no good. Here's Sato with the rebound. Outlet pass over to Byers, has an open lane, decides not to take it, fumbles the ball a little bit, hits the cutting Johnson, outside Byers, no good, Carr with the rebound. Here's Rockoff, over inside, gets the foul call, she'll go to the line. So, Derek, right now the only person playing who has points right now is Winter Beck.
Yep.
The sophomore out of Fayetteville.
Crazy.
So, this past few years, we've seen, Claudia Bridges and Ariana Saita were on Varsity as a sophomore.
Mm-hmm.
Last year it was Caroline. And we've just had a lot of younger talent coming through Fayetteville. So, what's your opinion on that?
I think it's awesome, you know. Getting the younger people, more younger people on the varsity team just makes it like in the future that they're just going to be the greatest. Like by the time that Winter Beck is a senior, she's going to be so good. Like if she's good right now, by the time she's senior and she's on varsity, it's going to be like top tier. So I think it's awesome that they're putting more younger players on the team and it's just going to result in more wins in the future.
Rogers. Missing a few there, but Beck ends up with the rebound. Here is Bridges in the corner, has Fires underneath, decides not to hit her, but Beck will reset up top. Her running around.
Ooh.
Here's the corner, hits Johnson inside, doesn't look at the basket, kicks out Byers, no good. Carr with the rebound. And the pass is picked by Lindsay. It's a 3-on-1 situation. Here's Bridges, short corner, yes. Rogers will call their first timeout. Beautiful execution from Fayetteville. Folks, we will be back with you in a minute.
We want to play. Please do your best to help us continue. Wear your mask, practice social distancing, and follow directives pertaining to seating requirements.
At Slim Chickens, we're known for our 100% all-natural buffalo wings. Fresh, delicious, and fried to perfection. Now available in two new dry rub flavors. Our house favorite, Cayenne Ranch, blends cool with a kick of cayenne. And lemon pepper brings tangy zest and a punch of black pepper. But hurry.
All righty, folks. We are back to action here in Bulldog Arena. Coming out of the timeout, we have Claudia Bridges with 14 points in the half, and Winterbeck with 9, Caroline Lyles with 5. We got Gracie Carr up underneath, gets it to go. Fires with the pump fake, middle drive. Here's the floater.
Unlucky.
No good, but she's going to go to the line.
Kind of lucky. Fayetteville rocking the neon pink socks now.
Rocking the Breast Cancer Awareness Month.
Yep.
Here is Brock off to start out for Rogers. We got Bridges picking up outside. Intercepted by Beck on the kickout pass. Has a wolf. Lovely switch his hands. Takes it all the way through 3 defenders. No good.
Aw. That was the second time she intercepted it at that same point right there. She can read a play like a book.
And that's going to be another timeout. And, folks, we're going to stay right here with you. 30 to 14 here, 5:26 left to play in the half. So, Derek, let's talk about some of the seniors tonight. We got Claudia Bridges and Ariana Seda and Allison Byers. All have been playing together since eighth grade year, even at Woodland Junior High School. And that is including Carly Johnson. So, Derek, when talking about these four coming into tonight, how big of an impact do you think they have on this team?
Well, I think they have a really big impact on this team. You know, they're really good players, all of them. They all do their little special thing when they're on the court. And I think this season they've been playing particularly harder because, you know, it's their senior year. They want to finish strong. So I think they're a really good asset to this team. And it's cool that they've been playing together for so long.
Here is Bridges with the crossover. Oh, my God. She doesn't know where she's going.
You're lost. Where are you going? Zero PR.
Zero earnings. Treadwell gets the 3 to go. There's an easy pick right there from Bridges. The official ruling is going to be out on Carr. And that'll be Fayetteville's ball. Subs coming in for Fayetteville. Here is Lindsay at the top coming in. The scoop shot.
Oh.
Oh. She ate that.
Yeah, she got right back up though.
I didn't see the official ruling. I think it was a... I actually don't know. I didn't see the official ruling. Top of the key 3. No good. That's going to be an over-the-back call on Carr. It's going to be her first personal. Here, Seda inside has... Johnson takes it like a champ, though. My gosh. She's eating that.
Yeah. Just saying Johnson reminds me of that one game. Johnson.
It's like 4 Johnson on the court at once.
Johnson.
No, there's 2 Johnsons on the court. There's Jayla Johnson,
too.
Oh. Forgot about her.
2 Johnsons. Johnson.
Please not this. I can't take it anymore. Johnson's second is good. Wide open, top of the key 3.
Dang!
That's good. Here is Lindsay kick out to Lyles trying to work some magic. Inside is Johnson, gets the layup to go.
Johnson. Johnson. Johnson.
Inside, Carr going up. Doesn't get the call. Here's Brockoff up top, getting picked up by Sato with 21 left to play on the shot clock. Here's the switch, cross court, inside, trying to take it in. The tip by Sato is right there, doesn't get anything. Here is Carr on the free throw line. Here is the scramble right here.
Whoa.
That was a, okay, this is a long possession.
Yeah.
And it's going to be that short for Fayetteville. My God.
That short.
That was a pretty sweet outlet pass, though.
Yeah.
From Seda to Bridges. Here is Carr at the top. Brockoff, far left corner. Or excuse me, wing. Trying to take it inside. Doesn't get anything there. Pulls up with the three. Yes!
Woo!
22-35, 2:55 left to play. Inside Seda, no good. Gets the tip though, doesn't get it back. Inside, Brockoff gets it denied by Lyles. Outlet pass. Oh, I couldn't really tell what happened right there.
Like, I think Claudia Bridges just, like, pushed it to Winterbeck.
Alrighty, folks. There's going to be a timeout called by Fayetteville. And, folks, we will also take a timeout, and we'll be back with you in a minute.
At Slim Chickens, we're known for our 100% all-natural buffalo wings. Fresh, delicious, and fried to perfection. Now available in two new dry rub flavors. Our house favorite, Cayenne Ranch, blends cool with a kick of cayenne. And lemon pepper brings tangy zest and a punch of black pepper. But hurry, get them while you can. Whether you're driving through, ordering online, or picking it up curbside, Slim's has you covered. Download the Slim Chickens app and order online.
We want to play. Please do your best to help us continue. Wear your mask, practice social distancing, and follow directives pertaining to seating requirements.
At Park Hill, the safety of our patients and staff remains our top priority. We are continuing to schedule in-person and telemedicine appointments. All OBGYN, primary care, counseling, and nutritional appointments remain available for patients to schedule. If you have any questions or concerns regarding an upcoming appointment, please call us at 479-521-4433. Park Hill Clinic for Women, a lifetime of comprehensive, compassionate care.
We are back to action here in Bulldog Arena. Fayetteville starting out with the ball out of the timeout. We got Lindsay up top trying to make a move and does with the middle drive. Floater is no good. Carr with the rebound out to number 23 out of Rogers. Once again, folks, we do not have rosters.
Whoa.
There's the tip by Winterbeck. A lot of hustle. Here's Brockoff inside, trying to make a move. Beck with the switch. Amazing defense coming from Fayetteville.
Yeah.
That was amazingly read right there. They switched. You saw Winterbeck come over. You saw Lauren Lindsay come over. And then you have the tip out of bounds with seven left to shoot. So they're going to, Rogers is going to have to get something going quick.
Yep. Shoot it from there.
She said, shoot it from there. Corner three. No good. It's like the first ever shot clock buzzer I've ever seen.
Yeah.
Well, here at least. Inside, doesn't get anything deflected out of bounds by Winterbeck. Inside Carr. Brock off with the bank three.
Has she missed like any shots like this whole game?
I don't think she's missed too many. Lindsay, quick corner three, no good. And there's Lyles with the rebound outside, going baseline on Carr. Doesn't get the call she wants, but Carr ends up with it. Here's Beck on the gamble, gets it to go. One man to beat, doesn't get it. Johnson with the deflected rebound. She just broke her own teammate. That was...
She said, you're lost, where are you going?
Inside, gets it to go. 27-35. And it's starting to come down. Derek getting some fan calls right here. We're building a fan base down
here.
We've got 11 to shoot. We've got Rogers with the ball. Here's the screen coming from Carr. Here's the kick out. Brockoff has 5 to shoot. Inside Carr, deflected by Lindsay. She's got to get it up over to Bridges. Pulls it.
Oh,
she didn't get it to go. That would have been fun. Alrighty, 37-27 is your halftime score. Folks, we will see you in a minute.
Washington Regional understands the world has changed, but one thing that hasn't is our commitment to your health and your safety. Providing safe, compassionate care is our top priority. If you need care, don't wait. Now and always, Washington Regional is here for you. Learn more at wregional.com/safecare.
We want to play. Please do your best to help us continue. Wear your mask, practice social distancing, and follow directives pertaining to seating requirements.
Fans, at this time, we direct your attention to the main court. Tonight, we are honored to recognize the seniors of the Fayetteville dance team for their dedication, their hard work, and their constant demonstrations of purple pride. We also thank their parents for their strong support and encouragement throughout their years here at Fayetteville High School. We greatly appreciate all of your contributions. Our first senior honoree tonight, ladies and gentlemen, Elizabeth Baker. Elizabeth is escorted by Michael and Catherine Baker. Elizabeth's plans are to attend the University of Colorado Boulder and study advertising and design. Ladies and gentlemen, Elizabeth Baker. Next, we honor Sophie Bizzell. Sophie is escorted by Catherine and Sean Bizzell. Sophie's plans are to attend the University of Arkansas, majoring in nursing. Ladies and gentlemen, Sophie Bizzell. Next, we have Ella Britt. Ella is escorted by Michael and Pamela Britt, and Ella plans to attend Hendricks College, not yet having decided what she will major on, but she'll figure that out when she gets there. Ladies and gentlemen, Ella Britt. Our next honoree tonight, Bailey Brown. Bailey is escorted by Matt and Mary Catherine Brown. And although undecided on where she will be attending college, Bailey does plan to major in biochemistry on a pre-med track. Ladies and gentlemen, Bailey Brown. Next, we honor Ava Carrington. Ava is escorted by Melissa and Aubrey Carrington. Ava plans to attend the University of Arkansas, pursuing a career in business and real estate brokerage. Ladies and gentlemen, Ava Carrington. Our next honoree this evening, Jill Cross. Jill is escorted by Ashley and Josh Cross. And Jill plans to attend the University of Arkansas, majoring in interior design. Ladies and gentlemen, Jill Cross. Next, we honor Alexandra Kerbo. Alexandra is escorted by Jeff and Tammy Vines Kerbo. Alexandra will be attending the University of Arkansas, planning to major in nursing. Ladies and gentlemen, Alexandra Kerbo. Our next honoree, Sarah Fundling. Sarah is escorted by Josette Klein and Jim Fundling, and Sarah's plans are to attend Georgetown University studying political science. Ladies and gentlemen, Sarah Fundling. Next, we present Colby Green. Colby is escorted by Candace Scamardo and Randy Green. Colby will be attending the University of Arkansas, majoring in pre-law. Ladies and gentlemen, Colby Green. Next, we honor Zoe Hahn. Zoe is escorted by Leanne and Eric Hahn, and Zoe will be attending the University of Arkansas, majoring in nursing. Ladies and gentlemen, Zoe Hahn. Our next honoree, Eliza Hapgood. Eliza is escorted by Tom and Adrian Hapgood, and Eliza plans to attend the university in Utah and wants to major in graphic design and photography. Ladies and gentlemen, Eliza Hapgood. Our next honoree, Kate Heinzelman. Kate is escorted by Andrew and Sherry Heinzelman, and Kate will be attending the University of Kansas, majoring in communications. Ladies and gentlemen, Kate Heinzelman. Next, we have Jillian Johnston. Jillian is escorted by Pamela, Brett, and Angel Johnston, and Jillian's plans are to attend the University of Arkansas, majoring in either environmental engineering or business marketing. Ladies and gentlemen, Jillian Johnston. Our next honoree, Megan Leach. Megan is escorted by Deborah and Eric Leach. And although undecided on where she will be attending college, Megan does plan to major in computer science. Ladies and gentlemen, Megan Leach. Next, we honor Annie Perrette. Annie is escorted by Roger and Lee Perrette, and Annie will be attending the University of Arkansas, majoring in business. Ladies and gentlemen, Annie Perrette. Next, we have Lily Runnels. Lily is escorted by Cass and Ted Runnels. Lily plans on going out of state, not having decided yet where, but will be majoring in human development and family studies, pursuing a career as a marriage and family counselor. Ladies and gentlemen, Lily Runnels. Next, we honor Lexi Sterling. Lexi is escorted by Josh, Ashley, and David Josh and Ashley Lester and David Lester. Thank you. Lexi will be attending the University of Missouri, majoring in broadcast journalism, minoring in political science on a pre-law track, with hopes to attend law school after her undergraduate career. Ladies and gentlemen, Lexi Sterling. Next, we honor Anna Taunton. Anna is escorted by Ty and Christy Taunton. Anna plans to attend the University of Arkansas, majoring in interior design, minoring in marketing. Ladies and gentlemen, Anna Taunton. Our next honoree, Anna Trumbo. Anna is escorted by Michelle and Sean Trumbo, and Anna's plans are to attend the University of Kansas. And although undecided on a major, she looks forward to attending college. Ladies and gentlemen, Anna Trumbo. Next, we honor Sarah Waller. Sarah is escorted by Matt and Suzanne Waller. And Sarah will be attending the University of Arkansas, majoring in marketing in the Walton College of Business. Ladies and gentlemen, Sarah Waller. Next, we honor Henley Whitehead. Henley is escorted by Phil and Cameron Whitehead. Henley plans on attending the University of Arkansas, majoring in communication sciences and disorders. Ladies and gentlemen, Henley Whitehead. And our final honoree of the evening, ladies and gentlemen, Megan Williams. Megan is escorted by Stacy and Adam Williams. Megan plans to attend the College of Charleston, majoring in business. Ladies and gentlemen, Megan Williams. Let's have another big round of applause. These are your seniors of 2021. Ladies, we wish you every success in your future endeavors. Please remember, you will always be a purple dog. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the seniors of your Fayetteville Dance Team 2021.
Just a young gun with a quick fuse. I was uptight, wanna let loose. I was dreaming a big.
Are you looking to buy or sell a home in Northwest Arkansas? We know the process can be very overwhelming. That is why finding the right real estate agent is so important. Look no further. Elsaw and Company is here to help. Our proven track record, strong negotiation skills, and experience in the market are your keys to a great buying or selling experience. Contact us today and give us the opportunity to earn your trust and your business.
Your internet service should keep up with the changing world. Ozarks Go is a local company bridging the divide with speeds up to 1,000 megabits per second. Whether you're working or studying from home, or playing video games and streaming your favorite shows, our service delivers. Connect and energize your internet with Ozarks Go from Ozarks Electric Cooperative.
We want to play competitive team activities. Please do your part to help us finish the season. Wear your mask, practice social distancing, and wash your hands frequently.
Slim Chicken's new dry rub wings are where it's at. House Cayenne Ranch dry rub that blends cool with the kick of cayenne, or classic lemon pepper dry rub that brings a tangy zest. Download the Slim Chicken's app and order online.
It could happen to me.
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 It did happen to me.
A heat stroke can happen to anyone, and it's 100% preventable. Always remember, prehydrate, hydrate, and rehydrate. For more tips on proper hydration, go to KendrickFincher.org.
Are you looking for a commercial space for your business? Choosing the right location can be a challenge. That is why finding the right real estate agent is so important. If you are considering buying, leasing, or selling commercial real estate, Elsaw & Co. is here to help. Let our years of commercial real estate experience, knowledge of the market, and customer relation skills benefit you. We know that you are busy, so let us help you. Give us a call today.
We want to play. We want to play competitive team activities. Please do your part to help us finish the season, wear your mask, practice social distancing, and wash your hands frequently.
And we are back here in Bulldog Arena. We got Fayetteville starting out with the ball for the second half. We have Beck, Lyles, Bridges, Lindsay, and Seda here for the Bulldogs. 37-27 is the score. Three timeouts apiece left. And we got Fayetteville already taking it out. We got Seda on the inbounds. That was right by us, but I don't really know what just happened. They called it off white, so it's going to go to Rogers. Up top, a quick three, no good. Here's Lyles on the kick out to Seda. She's got Beck on the middle drive. She's going to get called for a travel.
Dang.
Got a back cut there, but decides not to take it. Here is the baseline drive, gets it to fall. Only an 8-point lead here for Fayetteville. Here's corner, it's Beck trying to get something from Lyles underneath, decides to pan out. Here's on the kick out to Seda. Here is the pick, but Lyles is gonna get it with 18 left to shoot on the shot clock. We've got Bridges sitting out by the FHS logo. Getting picked up by Rockoff. Here's Seda getting picked up by Carr. Trying to get something going here with Lindsay and Lyles. In the corner, it's Beck getting a screen from Lyles. The middle drive, the kick out. Seda's corner three. Oh, I thought that was going in. Then it's going to be a shot clock violation. And that's going to go to Rogers.
Shot clock. Shot clock.
Lindsay gets on the floor, a wide open court for Rogers, and they convert on the two. 6-point lead now for the Bulldogs. We've got Bridges on the fast pace. Here we go, Lyles corner three, no good. Here's Beck with the offensive board. Gets it out to Bridges to set something else. And we've got Coach Rimmer wanting the timeout. So, folks, we will also take a timeout. 5:45 left to play.
Washington Regional understands the world has changed, but one thing that hasn't is our commitment to your health and your safety. Providing safe, compassionate care is our top priority. Learn more at WRegional.com/safecare.
We want to play. We want to play competitive team activities. Please do your part to help us finish the season.
Wear your mask, practice social distancing, and wash your hands.
Across the state of Arkansas, Farmers and Merchants Bank and the Bank of Fayetteville join you in cheering on our favorite teams. We applaud that extra effort that makes our schools and activities an important part of our communities more now than ever. Working as a team to make our communities better by helping you reach your goals, that's what happens at Farmers and Merchants Bank and the Bank of Fayetteville, home of me banking. Member FDIC.
And we are back in Bulldog Arena. We got Fayetteville starting out with the ball at the timeout. Already with 20 left on the shot clock. That's going to be a foul on Barakov, I believe. That's going to stay with Fayetteville going underneath with Beck inbounding the ball. Here's Lyles inside the turnaround. No good. Beck with the offensive board again. Trying to make a move, goes up, and it's good.
Number 14, Winter Beck.
She's got 11 along with Claudia Bridges, 18. 18 in the first half.
That is crazy.
Yeah. Inside, a good pass, gets it off, but Lyle's there for the deflection. Is going to get called for the blocking foul.
Uh-oh. Ariana Seda getting up, kind of limping.
First one is good, 32-39. Fayetteville still leads, 5:14 left to play in the quarter. Brockoff leading, Rogers scoring with 12, and Bridges on the Fayetteville side with 18 leading all scores. Got Seda going inside, cross court, over to Beck, her three, no good. With the rebound going to Rogers, they got numbers, they got Carr down low in the middle. Gets it inside the car, no good. Gets her own rebound, pulls it out. But up top, it's Brockoff trying to make a move on Lindsay. Takes it up with the right hand, no good. Here's Lyles out and running, loses her dribble there a little bit. But finds Lindsay, has Beck for the second chance. Absolutely. Here's the quick three off of a screen. Nothing but the bottom of the net.
Whoa.
42-35 now. Fayetteville still leads. Here is Beck getting double teamed. Has Bridges wide open. Top of the key three.
Oh.
But here's Beck. Finds the cutting Bridges. Has to take it out. Has. Okay.
That worked.
Just kind of faked everybody out there. Has Carr down low, wide open.
Oh.
No. Doesn't get it. Right now, Fayetteville and Roger just kind of trading buckets.
Yeah.
We've got Lindsay going over top, has nothing there. Decides to reverse it off the drop off to Bridges. Has Seda sitting in the corner, decides to take it herself with the floater. Lyles with the rebound.
Oh.
No good. Rogers is out right now. They have. Going up, taking it all the way with the right hand. No good. Here's Beck with the rebound. She's got Seda and Bridges on left and right, deciding to take it all the way with the Euro step. That's going to get called for the blocking foul.
They've had a lot of blocking fouls this Mounties team.
You don't see as many charges, I feel like.
Uh-uh.
Bridges, or excuse me, Beck will go to the line. Her first is good. Now, Derek, but what do you have to say about Winter Beck? Because she's a sophomore, and, I mean, once again, I've mentioned before about Rimmer liking to bring up the sophomores and some of the freshmen to play on varsity, because normally they're already good enough to play, such as Bridges and Lyles, I mean, before them, it was Goforth and winner Beck's older sister, Kariah. So what do you feel about her playing up on Varsity and already performing so well?
It's crazy to see already. You know, she's just such a good player. She can shoot. She can go crazy in the paint. You know, she just got fouled. Oh, but then she can fall, too. But then she can get right back up. So, yeah, she's a really good player. Happy. I mean, we're not going to be here to watch her play next year, but she's going to do some great things.
There's going to be a timeout, folks, and we will also take a timeout. 46-37 is your score.
Floor taken by Rogers.
We are back here in Fayetteville. Fayetteville starting out with the ball with Claudia and Seda sitting up top. Here is the pass inside to Beck, or excuse me, outside in the corner. But the drop off, the sweet pass inside to Johnson.
Oh!
Kick out a little bit too high over her head for Seda. And that's going to be a turnover Rogers ball. Right now on the Fayetteville scoring list, we have Claudia Bridges with 20, and then we have Winter Beck with 16, and then Carly Johnson is the next person up with 3. I think this is definitely one of the better games we've seen from Bridges and Beck. Normally, one is either dominating or supporting the other.
Yeah.
So, to see them both exploding for 20 and 16 like this is a fun sight.
Uh-huh.
Ooh, here's Lyle, short corner, no good. Seda with the rebound. That's going to be, he's going to step on the line. That's going to go to Rogers. Left alone,
oh.
Top of the key three, no good. We've got Beck attacking inside. The sweet pass inside to Lyles is no good. Lyles is going to the line. First is up and it's good.
Perfect.
I feel like there's been some pretty solid shooting here.
Yeah, definitely.
A lot better than previous games, this time from both sides, though.
Yep, both sides.
There's Lyle already with a quick steal. It's a 4-on.
Ooh. I saw the idea, but it was just the ball was too low.
Ooh. Brockhoff gets Beck to go with the ball instead of her right there, but Beck recovers nicely inside. Going to be a foul call. I'm trying to see what the ruling is. She's going to be in Caroline. And already Brockhoff is going to step out of bounds, and that's going to go to Fayetteville with Lindsay and Bridges setting up in the backcourt.
Oh.
Using the handles there, but Beck cannot convert on the three. Rogers is out and running. Fumbles the ball a little bit there, but Beck picking up outside on 23 over to two. Back outside. Corner three, no good. Here's Lyles. And they've got two running corner on the left side. They've got one outside. Here's Lindsay for three.
Oh,
yes.
That was deeper than deep. Shakespeare poetry.
Deeper than Shakespeare's poetry. That's pretty deep.
Yeah.
Trying to get the turnaround, gets a run rebound, and converts on the two. Here is Lindsay quick. Here is Lyles with the Euro step inside. No good. Gets
what?
A run rebound.
Oh!
Another offensive board from Fayetteville. Goes up with it. No good. Another offensive rebound. Doesn't get it. Doesn't have time to get it up, and not paying attention to the clock. Alrighty, folks. 51-39 headed into the fourth quarter. We'll be back to you after these messages.
Across the state of Arkansas, Farmers and Merchants Bank and the Bank of Fayetteville join you in cheering on our favorite teams. We applaud that extra effort that makes our schools and activities an important part of our communities more now than ever. Working as a team to make our communities better by helping you reach your goals, that's what happens at Farmers and Merchants Bank and the Bank of Fayetteville, home of Me Banking. Member FDIC.
Help us complete the season. Please follow all directives pertaining to seating requirements, face coverings, and social distancing.
The Elsong Company Real Estate Team has over 30 years of experience specializing in both commercial and residential listings and commercial leasing. Let Kurt, Andrew, and Brooke help you meet your real estate needs by calling 479-527-8865 or visiting their website at elsawco.com. As part of Lindsay & Associates, the state's largest real estate company, they look forward to working with you and showing you how we bring great neighbors together. Elsong Company and Lindsay & Associates, proud supporters of the Fayetteville Bulldogs.
Bulldog Arena, we got Roger starting out with the ball. We got Sato picking up top. Got Brockhoff on the back cut, decides not to hit her. Oh my, that was good offensive rebound. And gets the three to go. Brockhoff's got 15.
Oh.
Wide open corner three from Lyles.
Oh.
Go ahead.
Lyles! 3 point.
Got Brockhoff going up top. Middle drive with the scoop.
Sheesh. She does that a lot. She's like, scoop.
Bridges bringing out the handles. Has Lyles there in the short corner. No good. But Rogers has the rebound. They've got one running in the corner on the back cut right here. We've got one at the top.
Oh!
Lindsay's going to come from behind. It's a 2-on-2 situation. Has Beck running with her. Takes it all the way. Converts
Dang!
On the two.
She just stole that ball. Violated her.
And another steal happening on the exact same spot. But doesn't get it. Here is the kick out. She's going to step out of bounds. And that's going to be Fayetteville's ball. Here is Seda attacking inside, drops off. Byers outside. no good. Gets her own rebound. Here is Jayla Johnson outside, the sophomore out of Fayetteville, trying to spin her way into the lane. Oh. Doesn't get it to go.
Oh.
Here's Brockoff out and running. She is hustling.
Goodness.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, I'd be out of breath too if I was running.
Yeah.
Gosh. Inside, Brockoff has the corner coming around. Inside its car, throwing it too high, but there's a steal right here from Lindsay.
Whoa!
It's a 3-on-3 situation. Hits.
Oh.
Johnson trying to go up, but doesn't get it. And there's going to be a timeout by Rogers. Folks, we will also take a timeout, and we will see you in a minute.
We want to play. Please do your best to help us continue. Wear your mask, practice social distancing, and follow directives pertaining to seating requirements.
At Slim Chickens, we're known for our 100% all-natural buffalo wings. Fresh, delicious, and fried to perfection. Now available in two new dry rub flavors. Our house favorite, Cayenne Ranch, blends cool with a kick of cayenne. And lemon pepper brings tangy zest and a punch of black pepper. But hurry, get them while you can. Whether you're driving through, ordering online, or picking it up curbside, Slim's has you covered. Download the Slim Chickens app and order online.
And welcome back, folks, to Bulldog Arena. Sorry if you hear some stuff going on behind us. They're getting the student section situated.
Yep.
Brockoff, quick three off of the 2 feet, no good. Here's Bridges trying to wheel and deal inside. Here's the kick out to Byers, taking it back inside. Drops it off to Winterbeck, who goes in the lane, doesn't get it to go, but Lyles has the rebound, no good. Rebound Rogers. Quick three, yes.
Oh.
She's got 18.
18, goodness.
It's deflected out. By number two out of Rogers.
Wait, number three on the Mounties has 18 points?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. She's going crazy too.
Oh my gosh.
Right in front of her face.
Oh my goodness. She's got 23 right now. My gosh. Alrighty, we got Byers picking up. Up top, here's the switch with Winterbeck. Here is taking it inside. Doesn't get it to go, but the foul is called. First one is up and good. Here is the second, it's up and good. Quick crossover, here's the kick out, baseline drive, back out, Bridges deep three, no good.
What the?
My gosh, okay. So Ariana Sutter tried to throw behind her back.
Hit
Number three, Braca.
Yeah, and then it hit Sandhagen out of bounds.
Yeah.
So that's going to stay with Rogers. So they moved some of the student section.
Oh.
I think that's so they didn't have to social distance.
Oh, dang. Well, do what you got to do.
Do what you got to do. Here's inside Carr taking it up on Lyles. Gets it to go. Sato with the floater is no good.
Oh.
Brockoff going for 21. Oh, they knew what they were doing.
Yeah, they just got kicked out.
Lyles doesn't get it to go inside. Rogers with the rebound. Inside, taking it. Calls the foul. Seems to get a hand on there. That's going to be Seda's third, I believe. 59-51 with 2:43 left to play. This is a closer game than I feel like people expect.
Yeah, for real.
And
like
now it's 52-59. So, I mean, I definitely don't rule Rogers out.
Yeah,
They're definitely in this.
Uh huh. They've been playing pretty good.
Yeah.
I just noticed that the Mounties head, like the coach, he kind of looks like Jeff Bezos. Like he took off his mask, and I was like, he kind of looked like Jeff Bezos.
Yes, the CEO of Amazon is the Rogers Mounties head coach.
Did you see that Jeff Bezos is stepping down as CEO of Amazon later this year?
Why?
I don't know.
Interesting.
Yeah.
You know, I've already made my $5 today, so I'm good.
Yeah.
Here's Bridget trying to deal her magic in the corner.
Oh! What?
Gets it to go at the shot clock expires.
Oh, my goodness. She's going like, shoot. Pop it.
Here's Lyles with the rebound. Finds Seda. Cross-court pass over to Lindsay Beck.
Tries
to take it in the middle. Gets it to go. And one. Count it.
And one.
Folks, if we could show you a replay, we would.
Yeah, I hope. I wish we could.
That was a sweet move in the corner.
I want to watch that again. Oh, my God.
She did this little between the legs, and then she did this little snatch back. In the corner three. That was pretty sweet.
That was crazy. Uh-oh. Oh!
Back already with a steal.
Yay!
65-53. Ever since I said that this was a closer game, it hasn't been such a closer game.
No, you hexed them.
I hexed them. Already Bridges with another steal. Decides to slow it down with 1:04 left to play. Downhill is instead of dropping it off. Here is Lindsay outside. I believe they're trying to run the clock out now. We got 40 left to play with 5 left on the shot clock. Drops
Uh-oh.
It off into Johnson. Doesn't get it. That's going to go the other way to Rogers.
That kind of backfired.
A 0.4 difference between shot clock and game clock.
Oh!
It's pretty close.
Yeah.
Oh. 67-53 with 26 left in the ball game. Brockhoff goes up, misses it. Carr with the rebound, misses the short layup inside. Seda comes out with the rebound. And they're going to hold it, I believe, for the final seconds with 8, 6, 5.
There's
a lot of the student section is here. I didn't think there'd be this many.
What?
But you know what? As time expires, Fayetteville wins 67-53. Claudia Bridges with 26 and Winterbeck with 21. Alrighty, folks, make sure to stay for the boys game here in a little bit. My name is Coleman Stennett.
And I'm Derek Collins.
We'll see you in a minute.
Sheesh.